20 Feet from Stardom was one of the best documentaries. Such an intimate look at the music business. Morgan Neville won an Oscar for that. And now this, we all love Fred Rogers. We all wanted to be his neighbor. We were sad when he left the small screen. And now you bring Mr. Rogers back. The trailer gives me goosebumps. Aww. I'm sure you've heard that before.
I have.
What alerted you to an interest in Mr. Rogers?
Honestly, it was a conversation I had with Yo-Yo Ma, the cellist, that I was making a film with him, and one day at lunch, I happened to ask him, how did you figure out how to be a famous person? And he said, oh, Mr. Rogers taught me. And I kind of laughed. Really? And he said, no, really. He really mentored me over years to show me how I could use fame as a force for positive social change and not a weight around my neck. Wow. And when he finished saying that, a light bulb went off in my head, and I said, that's not the Mr. Rogers I thought of. I need to think more about this and dig into it. And that led me to making this film.
Now, having passed away almost 15 years ago, Mr. Rogers, I would assume that, does that make it harder in terms of just the documentary process?
Not necessarily. I mean, everybody else is still around, which is amazing. But there was so much material, 900 plus episodes of Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, plus just volumes of everything, letters and tapes. So it was really actually just difficult to dig through that material to bring him out, but the material was there.
Now, we have recently been deeply disappointed by some TV idols. Mm-hmm. When you go into something like this, is there a trepidation you might find out too much?
Yeah, in fact, when I first went to Pittsburgh, where he was from, and got into a taxi and told the driver what I was doing, he turned around and said, don't screw this up. Right. I can say that on television. Yeah. So there's this sense of, you know, look out for Mr. Rogers. Please tell us that he doesn't have a skeleton in his closet. And I'm here to tell you there is no skeleton. That, in fact, Fred Rogers, as opposed to Mr. Rogers, is actually kind of a more amazing person than Mr. Rogers.
Isn't that incredible?
Yeah.
Let's look at a clip from the movie. Watch this.
Low production values, simple set, unlikely star. Yet, it worked. Because he was saying something really important.
Love is at the root of everything. All learning, all parenting, all relationships. Love or the lack of it. And what we see and hear on the screen is part of who we become.
Okay, that makes me want to cry. Because it does take you back to when you were a little kid. And why did he mean so much to kids? What was it about that connection that kids felt?
He didn't condescend to them. I mean, that's the thing, is that he always spoke to them at their level. And parents tend to say to kids, don't worry about this, or you don't need to know about this. Fred Rogers was the opposite. He knew that kids were too smart to not notice when things were happening, bad things were happening in the world. So he said, I'm going to level with kids. I'm going to tell them that bad things happen, but explain it to them so they don't fear that. So well,
he talked about the love and how important love was, and or the lack of it. What about in his life? Did he have love? Did he have a nice childhood himself? Did you get into that?
He did. I mean, he had an isolated childhood. He grew up actually very wealthy during the Depression. And he was isolated from friends. He was sickly. So, and he was an only child until he was 12. So it was really making up these characters in his own bedroom as a boy that became the puppets. And he did all the voices for all the puppets on the show, too. So really, the roots of everything that became the land of make-believe happened in Fred Rogers' bedroom as a boy.
How long did the show air?
33 years nationally and several more regionally.
How many countries?
Only North America.
There's another clip I've seen where essentially it talks about race relations and how he was decades ahead of his time.
Absolutely. In his own subtle way, he reacted to things like the assassination of Martin Luther King by bringing on a police officer in the neighborhood who's African American. And when people felt that you know, blacks and whites couldn't share swimming pools, he went and put a kiddie pool on the set and had the police officer and him put their feet in the pool together. And then he dried the police officer's feet with a towel. You know, Fred was very conscious about the subtle imagery of all of that.
I suppose you enter into this as kind of not an investigation necessarily. When did you realize, oh my gosh, I have stumbled upon something that's going to be goosebump inducing the entire time?
Right at the beginning, he had done this amazing special 2 days after Bobby Kennedy's assassination. to help parents explain to children what had just happened. And it only aired one time. It had never been seen again. And when I went to Pittsburgh, it was the first thing I wanted to see. And when I saw that episode, wow, I knew the film would have everything in it that I wanted, you know, mm-hmm, all the depth and dimension. And he was a profound man.
Yeah.
Wow. We need more
affected
like him.
All of us, yeah.
No question about it. Won't You Be My Neighbor will be in theaters June the 8th. Academy Awards, of course, consideration, I think. Critics' Choice Documentary Awards. Wow. Morgan, nice to see you. Thanks so much.
Thanks so much.
Thanks, Morgan.